Hello, everybody. Only testing. So I would like to thank you for coming for this session. My name is Michel Pereira. I'm a solution architect for Amazon Web Service. I'm based in Brazil. I'm here with the customer, TV Global, that's going to show you how they built the second screen experience that is hosted on, that was used to make the interaction with the end user, that TV viewer. And now we are going to do an introduction of TV Global, the motivation behind this second screen application, the journey, lessons learned, what we got from this experience building the application, and what the customer got back to us, okay? And the achievements. And I would like to let you know that this session is a level 300, so we are going to show how to focus more on the application side and a few things in architecture, okay? And enjoy.
Thank you. So, hello everyone. My name is Fabio Castro. It's my first time here at re:Invent. And I'm from Brazil, as Michel said, and I work at Global TV. So I'm here to talk about our experience using AWS. Firstly, an introduction about myself and Global. We are from the research and development team and of the Global TV Technology Division. So Global is a Brazilian broadcast television. It has 90,000 employees with about 98 million people reached daily. Global has the largest entertainment content production center in the Americas. A little bit about myself. I have been working with technology since the end of the 90s. And I started working at Global in 2002. And I have been leading development teams since 2011. So what was our motivation and why did we use AWS? Our motivation for using AWS was to support a second screen application for Global. And the application was designed to support all Global TV shows. And the idea was to have only one application for all the schedule, including soap operas, news, entertainment, and sports. Our first launch was sports, mainly soccer games. And our focus was the World Cup. The following video shows more details about the project.
June 2014. Brazilian playing fields were the stage to the biggest sporting event on the planet, the FIFA World Cup. Globo, as the official national TV station, had the responsibility to bring the best and richest coverage to more than 200 million Brazilians. If, at every cup, Globo presents the most modern and innovative broadcast, in this edition, the challenge was bigger. After all, it was the party for the people most in love with soccer in the world, and every fan wanted to feel as if on the field.
Partiu pé direito!
To bring these millions of fans into the show, we created an extreme engaging experience, the Globo app.
Você tem o novo aplicativo da Globo, você usa aí o seu tablet, seu smartphone, você tem interatividades, você vai participando com a gente durante o jogo.
The fans would participate in real time, voting during the broadcast through polls released by narrators.
Vamos botar no aplicativo quem você quer que ganhe. Já começou. Alemanha 69, Argentina 31, amigo. Já imaginou argentino zoando a gente o resto da vida?
E temos o resultado da nossa enquete no aplicativo Globo. Quem você acha que é o favorito que vai passar nesse confronto entre França e Nigéria? 75% entendem que a França vai passar.
Developed by Globo's own team of programmers, the project offers information in a simple, fast, and dynamic fashion. Detailed statistics of each match, team lineups with information on each player, available to users at all times in real time. In addition, it was also possible to follow replays at different angles. The tool was available only on the second screen.
E continue acompanhando todos os lances da Copa. Tem aquela jogada linda das 14 câmeras em 14 ângulos diferentes, multi-ângulos para você escolher.
Besides, other features contributed to the high engagement of the viewers. A chat area connected to the main social networks raised the participation of fans. Before, during, and many hours later after each match, people commented on the plays and, of course, cheered.
Saque a sua, Júlio!
Since we're talking about a sporting competition, no action would be complete without the gamification component. Our app brought the feeling of a party to millions of houses throughout the country. We've created a competition between the viewers through soccer trivia and prediction games in real time.
Vai rolar um game hoje no jogo Uruguai-Inglaterra e você indo bem nesse game pode participar da Central da Copa de segunda-feira. Capricha no game!
As a prize, winners would participate live in daily editions of a special show about the World Cup.
Já temos a nossa convidada, pela primeira vez uma mulher, Márcia Cruvinel.
Assistir essa Copa foi diferente pra mim, porque conforme eu usava o aplicativo, isso prendia mais a minha atenção ao jogo.
Você mexeria no time do Brasil?
Eu acho que o problema do Brasil não é um jogador ou outro.
Você derrubaria o treinador, é isso? Derruba o Filipão, então.
Você tem imagem do aplicativo que tá aqui, gente? Vamos levantar a mão aí, ó. Para o Brasil,
boa.
Muito bem. Obrigado pela presença e parabéns aí pelo destaque no aplicativo.
A torcida tá agitada no Mineirão. Caprichou, que bateu!
Enquanto o jogo não termina, enquanto não confere o último ponto, você não tem a certeza de que você ganhou, entendeu? E muito engraçado porque as pessoas sacaneavam. Pô, como é que essa menina consegue adivinhar tudo? Consegue ficar em primeiro lugar? É mãe de Ná? Enquanto eu tava assistindo o jogo, eu torcia pelo Brasil e por mim ao mesmo tempo. Foi fantástico, foi uma experiência muito legal, assim.
Bate o Neymar, caprichou, bateu, vai gol, 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 gol!
Globo App, the most complete experience on a second screen.
So, back to the presentation, I will talk about our journey. Before using AWS, our main focus was on user experience at the mobile application side, and the back-end application was hosted on a single server in our own infrastructure. That's the point we started using AWS. During our first deploy, the idea was to keep the same application, but instead of hosting in our own infrastructure, we moved it to an EC2 single instance, which worked via Elastic IP. And to deliver our static files, we used the CloudFront with S3 as its origin. As you can see, it's not a complex architecture. As we all know, AWS has great services. These are the services that we used during our journey. We had to understand and try out all these services. But sometimes, even with the great self-service feature on AWS, and especially when you are building big systems, you will need help to extract the best of the AWS services. For that, we had AWS support. Not only did they provide us with a great support in our AWS services, but they also helped us with the load test, fine-tuning our system, and of course, in handling all the scalability issues. Michelle will give you more details about the AWS support.
So,
So at this time, I was working as solution architect. I work as solution architect for TV Global. So they bought support for us. And with the infrastructure event management, they can, our support team could help them find some bottlenecks on the architecture. Okay, so some components that do not scale it, and give us some tips on how to change the application to use this, to scale that out. For example, changing direct inserts into RDS and using SQS. So we provided this information to the global team, and they changed the updated the application to use this new part of the architecture. So they coupled it, so they split, I don't know the right term, but they split the application. And at this level, we could use more scalability, because sometimes they have, they got the call to act on the TV, there's a huge spike in the application. And we support helped us to do a load testing. So we stressed out all the components, like ALB, EC2, Dynamo, SQS, to see how the application is performing.
So, back to the architecture. Here we have the architecture that you used during the World Cup. As you can see, we increased the size of our system. And one of the big challenges was to prepare the system for a call to action. As you could see during the video, when the narrator called the app, we have an access spike. And to handle that access spike, we figured out in creating different layers to process all these access. And just in case if one model fail, it will not keep the whole application down. And the user still can access other features. I'll give you more details of each part of the architecture in the next slides. About the web server, we have two web services layers. The first one, web app, is responsible for processing user answers during a soccer game, for example, predicting a penalty kick. In that case, you use the SQS to kill the user answers. The web app is also responsible for processing all the chat messages. Our chat application is based on ElastiCache. The second one, App Server, is used to process user authentication using RDS and to connect to social networks. We use the RDS read replica to improve performance as well. Worker layer has two auto-scaling groups. The worker answer is responsible for reading the user answers from SQS, processing and putting them on DynamoDB. When a correct answer is given from the content management system, the worker ranking is responsible for calculating and sending the ranking data to broadcast via our CMS. We store the ranking data on ElastiCache as well to improve the read performance by the clients. The broadcast layer is responsible for pushing content to the clients. The content selected by the content management system operator are stored on ElastiCache and then consumed by the broadcast servers, which are accessed by the clients. A summary of our journey, we went from zero to hero in 6 months. We started from zero with AWS in January, with just one machine on EC2. And finished in June with 5 layers and up to 10 machines on each layer, as demonstrated on the previous slides. The team who developed the whole system includes the CMS and the app was formed by two developers, two DevOps, one quality assurance analyst, and one intern. Our two developers and the intern were focused on the application back-end and the application front-end. The quality assurance analyst worked together with the developers, testing a feature as soon as possible, instead of waiting for a bigger release. Our two DevOps were responsible for developing, deploying, and operating the infrastructure. Also, they were responsible for integrating the development, staging, and production environments. It's interesting to think that before using cloud computing, we had only heard about DevOps, but however, had never used them. Two of our developers actually became DevOps during the project. Today, it's difficult to think a new project without them. In the end, you learned some things that we would like to share with you here. About reliability, we learned that an architecture in multi-AZ is extremely important. One of our guidelines was to never store critical data on instances. And with that in mind, we built our application to store the data on AWS services. So in case we lose an instance, we don't need to worry about losing its data. This is why we chose to use instance store backed instance, also known as ephemeral store. And also, a software based on instance store backed instance could really help you to design a multi-AZ architecture. Shall we give more details about the instance store?
So about as they choose to use to store all the data outside the server, so they use it, a lot of RDS, Elasticache, and content from CMS going through RDS. We saw at some time in the architecture that it was a good option to use instance store, baked instance. So that's kind of instance that do not have EBS. So the data is not persistent. So this is very important because they could use more reliability and resilience building the application. So in just case one easy failure or one instance failure, the application can rebuild itself and be back online without anyone looking for that or have to bring everything back online again.
Regarding performance, we learned that load tests are extremely important to prepare a system for production environments. And heat replica and cache are very important to scale the system. Shall again give more details about the services.
Yeah, in this case, as recommended by our support team, we used a tool named Bees with Machine Guns. This tool was built from a Chicago Tribune newspapers here in, there's someone there, Chicago Tribune newspaper based in United States. So this is kind of tool that launches an attack to your infrastructure and just can stress out the components of your architecture. So you saw the architecture on presentation, we stressed out each item of that architecture, okay? And after that, we saw some bottlenecks, and we have to change the application. We give them the information that they need to change some parts of the application to use more redo replicas and Elasticache for most access data, like ranking. So we compute the ranking, and after that, insert that ranking into Elasticache, and they get that information and deliver that to the users that want to see how they are positioned into that ranking. So all this information was coming through RDS. So we have to change it maybe one night. I do not remember how many nights there. So I was allocated full at the TV Globo for this period. And we used a lot of redo replicas for all the services like ElastiCache and RDS too, okay?
Highlight some components used for performance and reliability. I would like to mention Nginx and Redis. You really can build great things combining those components. It's interesting that we have not think that our chat will be a success. The users started talking about everything, every time, 24 hours a day. For instance, we always had an access spike during our variety show in the morning. The users used the application to talk about the topics that are on the TV during the show. And the previous chat solution that we built was not scaling and not delivering the message very well. So in one night, we figured out to a solution to that scale, and we could build it fast. For this, we used the Nginx and Redis. That components helped us with our headaches. Just give them a shot. About cache using Nginx. Here we have a piece from our Nginx conf file that shows how we use the Nginx proxy cache to optimize our service, making a faster response and avoid unnecessary access to our backend. In the line one, we have the path to save the cache file. The parameter keyzone indicates the cache name and the default expiration time, in that case, 5 minutes. The line two, we have the where held to be cached. The line four indicates the cache name to be used. It uses the same name we set in the keyzone parameter. The line five indicates the responses accepted and the expiration time, in that case, 24 hours. And finally, the line six indicates the cache key. During the World Cup, we needed to optimize the network traffic. For that, we used the HTTP Lua model with Nginx. Here we have the script that we developed to process the response before the client received it. We used a carry parameter called timestamp to do the process before returning the JSON. We're great two developers are here, DevOps are here, and I'm sure they can give you more details during the conference. During the development process, we learned that test-driven development, behavior-driven development, continuous integration, and continuous delivery gave us the necessary courage to keep going, especially during crisis moments. Those techniques and tools, such as Jenkins, Git, and Chef, helped us to keep the development process sustainable. And last but not least, the most important thing, keep your software simple. I'd like to share some achievements with you. Our app is available for iOS and Android, and during the World Cup, was included in the featured apps list on the Apple Store. We had more than 800,000 downloads during the World Cup alone, and about 150,000 unique users per day during the World Cup. The users' feedback are very important to us, and we moved from 3.0 to 3.8 stars on Google Play. More than 20,000 people rated our app during the World Cup. So, thank you very much for your attention.
So, I would like to thank you. I appreciate your time here. So here is our emails, and we are taking questions here on the end of the ISLO. So there's a Q&A space there that will be there with the team, with the TV Global team, and we'll be happy to answer all your questions. Thank you.